In other local corporate headlines, Union Bank secures the Philippine Central Bank's approval to operate as a virtual asset service provider. This makes it the first and only universal bank in the country to offer mobile crypto trading. The new feature, which will be rolled out in the fourth quarter, will allow Union Bank clients to directly buy and sell Bitcoin through its app. Meanwhile, Manila Water allots 1.15 trillion pesos in investments until 2047. Its pledge comes as it seeks an extension of its concession deal with Metro Manila's water regulator. The water concessionaire also eyes tapping 475 billion pesos to develop and maintain its facilities from 2038 to 2047. As for Dennis Uy's IT firm Upson International, it further strengthens its supply chain capabilities by developing a new warehouse in Manila. The facility, located close to the port of Manila and several tech suppliers, is set to be completed by December this year.
A U.S.-based think tank raises financial red flags on San Miguel Global Power's fossil fuel expansion. The Institute for Energy Economics and Financial Analysis says volatile fossil fuel prices make the company's expansion of coal and natural gas-fired power capacity susceptible to financial issues. The think tank added the company's shift from coal to LNG could worsen the situation, noting LNG is a more expensive fuel and is expected to remain costly. The wholly-owned subsidiary of San Miguel Corporation is the largest power producer in the Philippines. It controls 4,719 megawatts of operational power capacity. The Philippine government is poised to borrow over 2 trillion pesos for its outlay next year. The vice chair of the House Appropriations Panel confirmed this on Tuesday as plenary debates for the 2024 national budget kick off in the lower chamber. Congresswoman Stella Kimbo says 43% of next year's spending plan would come from borrowings, while the remaining 57% will be sourced from local revenues. This is seen raising the country's already ballooning debt, which stood at 14.24 trillion pesos in July.
The macroeconomic assumptions adopted in this general appropriations bill are with sound basis. Yet, it is not an easy task to defend such parameters, considering that the Philippine economy faces external headwinds. We need the economy to grow so we can meet our revenue targets, support our spending plans, narrow down our deficit, and reduce our debt burden over time.
Also lifting sentiment a little, a more optimistic growth outlook from the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, or OECD, for 2023. The Paris-based body says the global economy proved more resilient than expected in the first half of the year, with stronger than expected growth from the U.S. offsetting weakness in China and the Eurozone. It now sees the world economy growing at 3%, better than its previous forecast of 2.7%. It also raised its projection for the U.S. to 2.2% from 1.6%, but the OECD says the outlook remains weak as risks, including the impact of tighter monetary policy, still tilted to the downside. It adds a sharper-than-expected slowdown in China could possibly hit growth around the world. For 2024, it sees global growth falling to 2.7%. It also projects economies in the euro area and China to slow further. Despite that, the OECD says central banks should keep interest rates high until clear signs of inflationary pressures have subsided.